Welcome back. The St. Vincent and the Grenadines Teachers Union, SVGTU, is alarmed and extremely concerned about the deteriorating conditions at the Adelphi Secondary School and calls on the Ministry of Education to take immediate action and implement steps necessary to correct the situation. The union contends that the school is currently unfit for use as it poses a significant threat to the health and safety of staff and students and other users of the building. The SVGTU has brought the matter to the attention of the relevant authorities to date. Very little or nothing has been done to effectively address the matter. Yesterday, 14 teachers staged a sick-out, resulting in no classes for the day. IKtv is uncertain for how long the sick-out will continue. A call has come from the SVGTU to the Ministry of Education to speedily bring a result into the deplorable conditions at the Adelphi Secondary School. The SVGTU said it's alarmed and extremely concerned about the deteriorating conditions at the learning institution. The school is said to be infested with termites, rodents, mosquitoes, as well as decaying structure, making the school unfit for use, and these problems create a fear and anxiety among staff, students, and parents alike. The union has urged its members to desist entry to the school until the authorities take immediate actions and steps to address these concerns. Speaking on the radio program last evening, Senator Julian Francis, Minister of Transport, Works and Local Government, said that he is aware that the situation at the Adelphi Secondary School looks gruesome and that work has to be done. The minister said that plans were put in place for officials at the Ministry of Education and Braxter to sit months before the summer vacation and come up with a program of work based on reports submitted and inspections done at various schools. Francis said that with funds being tight, they tried to shrink the budget, and somehow Adelphi slipped through. The Mustique Charitable Trust, in collaboration with the University of the West Indies Open Campus St. Vincent and the Grenadines, will officially hand over bursaries to three open campus students on Thursday, October 20th at 9:30 a.m. The ceremony will be held at the conference room of the open campus and will be addressed by head of open campus, Mrs. Deborah Dalrymple, and administrator of Mustique Charitable Trust, Mrs. Lavinia Gunn. The bursaries include presentation of a laptop to each recipient. This year's awardees are Ms. Shari Roberts, B.S. Social Work, Ms. Dawn Samuel, B.S. Management Studies, Ms. Janelle Thompson, B.E.D. Literacy Studies. Just days after Speaker of the House of Assembly, Jomo Thomas, took to Facebook to blast telecommunications company Digicel for, quote, raping Vincentians' pockets, Digicel has announced Digicel Facebook Flex, a new product that allows Vincentians free access to the popular social networking site. A condensed version of the Facebook Flex allows customers to like, share and comment on posts, update their statuses, send and receive instant messages without incurring data charges. However, to access premium content like photos and videos, customers will be given the option to use their current data allotment, activate the data plan, or browse using Digicel's PayGo service. Canadian investors who plan to establish a resort at the Moncton and Peter's Hope area on the western side of mainland St. Vincent have completed payments for the lands. This, according to Prime Minister Dr. Ralph Gonsalves, speaking on WFM's shake-up program on Tuesday, October 18, 2016. Dr. Gonsalves said investors have already paid EC $3 million for the lands owned by the government, but have now paid the additional $4 million for the lands valued at $7 million EC dollars. Dr. Gonsalves said the transaction is being made complete now, so the investors would be in possession of the land. Speaking dollar for dollar, Prime Minister Dr. Ralph Gonsalves on Monday, 5th October, said the government is about wealth and job creation in the project at Peter's Hope and Mount Twain.
So James paid $5 million for the whole is 681 acres. Say that $5 million in 1989-1990 will work now close maybe to $10 million. I'm talking dollar for dollar now.
Yes.
It wouldn't reach that amount. But I am giving you, I'm giving the largest latitude in a big. I'm being very generous.
Yes.
But I sell in 36 of it for $7 million. And to collect in stamp duties when the villas are sold, another $8 million easy. Are these people mad? When we are about wealth creation and job creation, and when farmers will have their produce. The farmers of Waden from Barley, for instance.
This morning on the OMG Talk Show, Bert Francois told listeners that the NDP is about getting the Argyle International Airport up and running, but not at the expense of the Vincentian taxpayers' pocket.
The party is for the position that the airport has reached a stage that you have to try and complete it.
Right.
Get it functional.
Right.
But they are not for taking every cent out of the Vincentian taxpayers' pocket to finish it.
Mr. Francois said that we cannot sell out the Vincentian lands to finish the airport. Following Dwight Bings Joseph's questions to a situation, Mr. Francois suggested a proper feasibility study be done before any action can be taken.
Your major made a good point. It's like selling out the family silver. We can't sell out all of our lands and prime estate here and Beckwith and Canawan and all about just to finish the airport.
So where should the money come from?
If there's a proper feasibility study, you need to explore. You say China, brilliant idea.
So will you put the project on hold?
China, you have Caribbean Development Bank, World Bank. I don't know if at that stage you'd like to come in. I can't tell you exactly the money will come from. There could be investors who may want to complete it. But I could tell you, I personally do not agree that the taxpayers of St. Vincent Grenadines must continue to pump money into this airport without audited financial statement, without proper completion date, at the expense of their own health care and other benefits.
More local news when we come back.